Everyone, my name is Katie. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to do the OtherTube oldie tag. I'm like semi shocked I'm still on YouTube, honestly. I do want to shout out this amazing friend shirt real fast though. Woo! I was so excited about this sweater. Okay, so I saw that Holly Davis did this and I was like, oh my gosh, I need to do that in December. I started at the very end of December and it was mostly because Emily Bourne told me to try it out. She had just started hers and we had like just become friends in the writing community, like 2017, like early 2017 was when I first like started getting into the writing community, and it took me till the end of 2017, yes, to get a YouTube channel. And I mostly did it because I love Christmas time, and so my first video besides my newbie tag was about my Christmas tag about my characters. Boy, I think Crafted, I think. A lot of that has since been taken down. When I rebranded with Katie Knightley, a lot of videos got taken down, so good luck trying to find those. So question one is, how long have you had your AuthorTube channel? I got started in December of 2017, and it was like around my birthday. I think it was like mid to late December, definitely before Christmas, so I could do my Christmas tag. Number two, what aspect of writing have you improved since joining? Early 2017 is when I first got my critique from Crafted, and was told I need to work on the craft. And so I went through like KM Wyland's website and read a bunch of character and story and plotting, and eventually found Save the Cat. Aspect of writing would just be understanding the fundamentals. I think knowing Save the Cat plus Romancing the Beat, I think just in general my niche is better, my niche in the like contemporary romance realm, because I started off with fantasy. And so I think just like honing that skill, that genre, that age group, the beats and the outline and like what's needed. Like, I've grown so much since December of 2017. I've written a lot of books since then, and I think I've just gotten better overall. I think just completing like character arcs and story arcs and creating a tighter story where it's not meandering everywhere, putting on the necessary bits in a story. There was a lot. There's been a lot in 3 years, you guys. What are your biggest writing accomplishments since starting your channel? I got into Author Mentor Match in February or March of 2020, so that was really cool. I'd almost made it to Pitch Wars in 2019. Just in general, just having written as many drafts as I have. Granted, like, some of them need revisions still, but I'm still really proud of that fact. If ever I had money to self-pub one day, if I didn't get into TradPub, like, I have a lot of source material to do that with. Has your drafting style, plotter, pantser, planter, evolved since you began your channel? Yes. My first ever book, which was a prophecy thing, was totally pants the whole way through, and then I was like, dang, this is garbage. And then Crafted, I had to revise a few times. I've gotten more plotter as time has gone on, but I have learned that I need a very, very loose outline because I change it while I write. So I'm still a plantser. I still have those key things I know about, but I plants all the middle, all the things that I need to keep track of while writing so I know to bring back later. So like slightly more plotter now, but kind of the same probably. If you plan to publish, has your publishing path goals changed since joining? I came into it wanting to TradPub, and I still would like to TradPub. I'm now thinking of like doing novellas, and so I'd like to maybe hybrid and do indie pub for like Christmas novellas or my fantasy novella ideas that would like become a full like anthology or whatever. All of this is like in the future though, because we're working on like other stuff involving money, so that'll be like down the line when I can pay for like editors and cover design, or if like I just do that on my own somehow. I would love to learn graphic design stuff and all of that. I love art. I don't think I'm great at it, but you know, you practice it like you practice your writing craft, right? Six, what is something writing or channel related you've learned the hard way? Oh, that sometimes people just aren't gonna care. It's hard. Growing a base of buddies, of writing buddies, of critique partners, of beta readers, that part's been really hard. I thought it was going to be more like, yeah, I'll read your book, but I mean, I'm super selective in what books I read of other people's as well, so I'm glad to have found like certain people that I switch with. Channel related, I love talking about my books, but other people don't. So I've learned that things I post on my channel probably aren't interesting to a lot of people. So I've had to deal with like, do I still wanna talk about it because I wanna talk about it and not really get views or comments, or should I cater to my audience? And I've tried to do a mix of both because I do just love coming on here and talking. I think YouTube is kind of changing. I know I'm changing where I don't really have time to watch videos. And so that might be the case for other people where they just don't have time to watch my videos. And so I'm trying to make them shorter, but I totally get it if like they're doing their own thing. That's just something that I've learned and that I've come to accept. If you caught my video with Nathaniel Rust, we talked about social media and pressures and like everything on our plates. And there just comes a time where you gotta stop comparing yourself to other people and just do you and be okay with what you're doing, or not be okay with it and do better or change or whatever. And so that's kind of the mindset that I have now. It's like, I want to make these videos and I'm gonna post them up, and if I get 30 views and 2 comments, like, cool. Like, I'll take it because I just want to do it, you know? It's fun for me. So even if I'm talking to myself. Writing related, learned the hard way how freaking long it takes to get published, how long it takes to get an agent, how long that whole process is, and how patient you have to be through everything. I really thought it was gonna go faster, and even like, it's been, you know, 3 years since I've started writing, and I have grown in that time. I think this year has been a ton of growth. I think I was also growing in 2019, and so I just had hoped to have gotten something sooner, like an agent sooner by now, but I definitely worked on revisions about a lot of my books this year, so I wasn't really querying, so I couldn't be like, oh, I, you know, didn't get an agent this year. Like, I didn't try this year. I had a lot of revisions to do to get a lot of books ready for next year. So 2021 will hopefully be a big year for me. But looking back on like 2017 December, baby Katie thinking she was gonna get an agent in a year, like, just, it's laughable. And be published by the time I have goals, but oh my gosh, by the time I'm 35 would be cool. By the time 40's up there, my god. In what ways has AuthorTube changed since you started your channel? I agree with Holly on this. I did a lot of book tags in the beginning and AuthorTube tags. I love talking about my characters, and like two of those books, I think, or three, I'm not even working on right now. Like, they're so far on the back burner. And so like, I'm glad I got to go through my videos and just like delete all of those. I think a lot of people are doing tags. Some are bringing it back a little bit now, but it's become a lot of like writing sprint focused, which is awesome. Vlog style focused, which I hate piecing 1,000 clips together, so I don't do that. It just takes more time for me to do that, and I'd rather just do one take on a camera and go for it. And so I'm probably not gonna, you know, be with them doing the vlogs, but there was a lot of writing craft style tips and things, and then a lot of criticism towards that for people who were like indie publishing and not following their own advice. There's been like a lot of drama and a lot of tea since starting, and so I think that has changed the way a lot of people do videos. I think they're more chatty style like this, which I love. And I love just putting it on in the background while I'm doing other stuff. But like I said, like, I've been able to watch less videos now. Like, I'm definitely selective on whose I watch, which stinks because there are people that I would like to keep up with, but like, time, you know, we got our own stuff. So I get it, you know, it is what it is. What is something that frustrates you about AuthorTube? Ah, so many things. No, I'm just kidding. I don't know. If I'm being supremely honest, I wish that I had formed a tighter group with some of the girls on AuthorTube so that I could do collabs with them and writing sprints with them and things like that. Because I think we got started around the same time, but like, didn't really talk with each other till 2018 maybe. And I just wish I had formed tighter friendships with that. But for like AuthorTube itself, all that tea was just nonsense. Like, I don't like drama, so that, but really know otherwise. I don't know that I'm frustrated by it. I don't know. Algorithms? I don't know. 9, what is your hope for the future of AuthorTube? I have no idea. If you caught, again, that video with Nathaniel Ross, I talked about how I don't even know if I'll have one after I do the panel for the writing community convention. The future, I just hope, like, I would love for authors who are published to stay on YouTube and talk about things. I love when Kim Chance did that. I totally know, like, and respect why she quit, but I think that insight knowledge is really good. That's why I really like that Alexa Dunn is on there and a few others who are trad published, because I feel like there's a lot of indie published ones on there, and, like, I need that too. Other people need that too. You know, a lot of people want to go that route, but I would love to see more trad, like, behind the scenes talks, which maybe you're not allowed to do, so maybe that's why they're not out there, or people get busy, but my hope is that it continues, even if I don't. I enjoy hearing about people's books and seeing what they're up to. It's a nice way to catch up. I know a lot of people are migrating over to Instagram and trying to do that there, and I try to keep up with people's stories over there because it is more bite-sized and easier than watching, like, a 30-minute YouTube video, but I don't know. I just hope it keeps growing. I know there's a lot of smaller channels, and it's hard to make your way in the world with all the big channels out there. Share some oldie wisdom for newbie author tubers. Have patience. keep at it. Figure out what your niche is, and if you want to go the whole algorithm route, like Sunny Leonarduzzi, is that her name? She has a lot, like, of looking at what videos did best and then, like, making more of that. Like, I don't do that, but if you really want your channel to grow, like, there's strategies. And just forming a group, oh my gosh, find a group of new author tubers like you and just do stuff together, have collabs together, market for each other, advertise for each other, and just have fun. It's a hard space to kind of crack into, but be thankful for every, when you hit 25, when you hit 50, when you hit 100 subs. I'm still hanging tight at 500. I don't see it going anywhere, but I'm thankful to have gotten that high, because in the beginning, you know, like, every single one is so important. And yeah, just do what you love. If you like the videos you're making, it's gonna show. And I mean, if you need to cater to your audience a bit too, just make it something that you and them enjoy, or maybe it's, like, tips that you're already looking into and are just sharing it. Don't, like, put a ton on your plate. Don't try to go crazy. I used to do 3 videos a week starting out, and that was just nonsense. I do 1 now, and with all my, I'm doing releases after I changed my name to Katie Knightley, so I have a lot coming out now. I don't know, just, That's like general stuff, but I guess, like, good lighting, good sound, good camera quality, good thumbnails. There's, like, tons of tips on YouTube if you just search, like, how to start a YouTube channel, AuthorTube channel. But yeah, I highly recommend finding a writing community, because they're gonna go with you not only with your videos but with your books as well. Like, find that same genre, age group, niche, and, like, be best friends. That's, like, my best advice, because that's what I wish I had done. I hope that y'all enjoyed this video. It's been 3 years rocking this channel, if you could call it that. I still love being here. It just is time consuming, and it's something that's on my plate that, like, I don't, it might be the first thing to go if I had to cut something. But thank y'all for watching this video and supporting me and commenting and liking and sharing and all that goodness. I'm so thankful for each of y'all. And if y'all have also done the oldie tag, please let me know, because I'll go check it out. And I will link the original one down below. Thank y'all so much. I hope y'all have a wonderful end of year, and I will see y'all later. Bye.